إن الحمد لله، نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله تبارك وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله تعالى فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبده ونبيه ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, seeking His help, His forgiveness. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the beginning to protect our hearts in our iman and increase it in our hearts. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. I bear witness there is no God but Rabb al-Izzah, subhanahu jalla fi ulah. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is last messenger and last prophet of Rabb al-Izzah jalla fi ulah. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, this is Ahmed Abu Saif coming to you from Dallas, Texas, hitting the road yesterday 8 a.m., arriving here around 9 a.m., driving. Just for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seeking your help, because we got a church over there and alhamdulillah 1 year ago started to be a masjid. Allahumma laka alhamd. Every single day we have at least 100 people coming in and out just to learn, seeking learn Sharia and Islamic study. That church became a masjid and became an academy. The title over there, or the name, is American Imams Academy. And we are trying our best to like create and maintain imams. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us for that goal and help us to achieve our aim in this dunya, to reach al-jannah together. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. You can now, before starting the khutbah, check if you still have your wallet or not. You know, you're going to pay money at the end of the khutbah, insha'Allah Rahman subhanahu wa ta'ala. But before that, when Sheikh Muhammad asked me yesterday at the night, what are you going to talk about tomorrow? I told him, you know, I just remembered, subhanallah al-qadir, the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam comparing with my situation driving during the night, you know. And he remembered the hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he said, "Man khafa adlaj." If you have any kind of fearing about something, you're going to go really early before even your enemy expecting you're going to go up. وَمَنْ أَدْلَجَ بَلَغَ الْمَنْزِلِ. If you're going to go early, you're going to achieve your destination for sure, inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam added for that, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَلَا إِنَّ سِلْعَةَ اللَّهِ غَالِيَةً. I don't know how can I translate the sil'ah, but the material, commandment, whatever, but this is the sil'ah. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is offering for us. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is offering is al-jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إن الله اشترى من المؤمنين أنفسهم وأموالهم. What is the reward which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave? بأن لهم الجنة. This is the things which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gonna give it to anyone will try. Can we say sailing himself for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Can we say that? Am I doing that right now when I come into you? Are you doing right now when you leave your work to come to the masjid to pray? Are you doing that when you're giving a charity or a sadaqah or helping the people or offering like helping for anyone? Are we doing that? For sure. When we come to pray five times a day, we are selling something for رب العالمين سبحانه وتعالى just for the sake of Allah جل في علا. Now, we will try to compare between the متاع الدنيا and متاع الآخرة. What do we have over here? What are the blessings which the people have in the dunya? And what are the blessings which the mu'mineen especially have in this dunya too? And what they're going to have in the akhirah? I remember now what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا بَنِي آدَمَ خُذُوا زِينَتَكُمْ عِنْدَ كُلِّ مَسْجِدٍ وَكُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا وَلَا تُسْرِفُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُسْرِفِينَ شيخ آدم الآية قولي اللي بعدها نسيت خذوا زينتكم عند كل مسجد وكلوا واشربوا ولا تسرفوا إنه يحب المسرفين قل من حرم زينة الله نعم قل من حرم زينة الله التي أخرج لعباده والطيبات من الرزق This is my point قل هي للذين آمنوا في الحياة الدنيا خالصة يوم القيامة What Allah سبحانه وتعالى is giving to the people It's gonna be common between everybody But the mu'mineen gonna get their part in this dunya and they're gonna have something special when they come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be in the Jannah. You know what I mean? Now, do you have car? The disbelievers have cars, you know? But you have car. I remember one time I was selling my car. When the person asking me, okay, what is the best thing in this car? I told him, وَاللَّهِ مَا مَشَتْ أَبَدًا فِي مَعْصِيَةِ اللَّهِ That's the silliest thing. يعني, I told him, I never drove it for the sake of anything else, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the benefit of the car. Come on, man, you're kidding me? But it was true. I never drove it for any other goal, you know? This is my life. This is my work. I'm just going to the masjid, coming to home, and so on and so on. This is our life. This is خَالِصَةً لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا Imagine, you're walking, you're sitting, you're eating, you're sleeping, you're laughing, everything in our life for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the part of the life. We're living that. We're feeling that. We are enjoying that. This is our life. We are really different with the other people that are already living around us. We are surrounded by the other people, but they're not just living for the sake of Rabbil Alameen subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we're going to talk about the characteristics of the mu'min, we're going to start together. Let us read from the beginning of the Quran. We're going to find what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about al-muttaqeen. ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِمَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْكَ وَمَا أُنْزِلَ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ وَبِالْآخِرَةِ هُمْ يُوقِنُونَ أُولَئِكَ عَلَى هُدًى مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ وَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ If you're looking at success or successful, you're going to find the mu'mineen had the best or the highest level of success. Because of what? Because of that characteristics. They believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, performing the salah, and they are believing in the past and the present and the future, and they are looking just for the sake of Rabbil Alameen subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us move to find another ayah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ This is our race. We are raising each other to achieve our goal. What is that? مَغْفِرَة The forgiveness. Once we have the forgiveness, our names gonna be indicated for the Jannah. Nothing else. وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared The Jannah للمتقين الذين يؤمنون الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم ذكروا الله فاستغفروا لذنوبهم ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله. We need to study all of that characteristics. The attributes of the mu'min needed to be studied. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help all of us to open the mushaf to read the characteristics of the Muslim, of the mu'mineen, of Ahlul Jannah, the people of the Jannah. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about all of them in the Quran. We can move together to find another prescription or description of the people of the Jannah at the beginning of Surah Al-Anfal. And you're gonna find a big part of the Surah Al-Furqan when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَانِ الَّذِينَ. And you can say يمشون على الأرض هونا إذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما يقولون ربنا اصرف عنا عذاب جهنم إن عذابها كان غرام لا يدعون مع الله إلى أن آخر لا يقتلون النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق لا يزنون. All of that characteristics in Surah Al-Furqan. And we miss something in Surah Al-Mu'minun. And all of that as talking about how can we get this Jannah. Because of that, we need to, how can we say it, like implement our Islam, performing our deen, saying yes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when He's asking us to do something, saying no for the shaitan when he's whispering to us. How can we achieve our Jannah? That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran. For the dunya, why we busy with that? Why? The question, لماذا شغلنا كل هذا الشغل بالدنيا؟ قال الله تبارك وتعالى زينا للناس. The شيطان سبحان الله is trying to make the dunya beautiful, showing you the dunya in your eyes. It's like lightly. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ أَأُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِخَيْرٍ مِّنْ ذَٰلِكَ. And I tell you something better than all of that materials in the dunya. لِلَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا. For the muttaqeen, عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the jannah. What's your goal? Qarun. Do you remember what Qarun did? But before that, what he had? The keys, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described, needed like a few strong boys or guys, you know, just to hold the keys. What about that? Safe. Subhanallah. But at the end of the day, he was under the feet of the people. They already knows what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised the muttaqeen, and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gonna give them in the akhirah. قال الذين أوتوا العلم ويلكم ثواب الله خير لمن آمن وعمل صالحا ويلقاها إلا الصابر. سبحان القدير. Back to our goal, al-jannah. Close your eyes and try to imagine yourself, you are in the jannah, and who you gonna meet there? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh, over there is Ibrahim alayhi salam. Oh, I can see Nuh ala nabiyyina alayhi salatu wa salam. This is Musa alayhi salam. And this is Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Talha, Zubayr, Abdullah ibn Amr, Abdullah. Okay, imagine. Just close your eyes and imagine yourself over there. Can we drink from the hawd of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Just going back to drink and coming back to the Jannah. Imagine. When the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam described to us one of the trees of the Jannah, you know, it's like covering like 70 aman masirat jawad yasiru fi dhilliha al-jawad al-mudammar 70 sanatan la yaqta'uha. You know, the strong horse is running 70 years under the shadow of one tree. Imagine when the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam talked about إن أهل الجنة يتراءون الغرفة. يا الله, when you see your house in the Jannah from the long distance or far away from that, سبحان القدير, Allahu Akbar. Imagine, I don't want to talk about, I don't want to talk about al-Hur al-Ain. I don't want to talk about the rivers over there. I don't want to talk about the foods over there, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already described. Just read Surah Al-Waqi'ah and see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said and how many kinds of food Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised the mu'mineen. This is our goal. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله الملك الحق المبين وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبده ونبيه ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. My dear brothers and sisters, subhanallah, I used to come to Masjid al-Huda since 2016 in the old building. Do you remember that place? Do you remember that place? What the situation was over there? Subhanallah al-Qadir. Masjid في مكان بسيط متواضع جدا, really humble place. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us a chance to be here right now. Alhamdulillah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us a chance to bring our children with us to enjoy their time here, to learn Quran, to study, to do whatever you are doing here. Alhamdulillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we are trying to do the same over there. I left Toledo, Ohio, I used to come over here since 2011, maybe 2011, 2012. Subhanallah. And I moved Toledo 2016 to Dallas area, Dallas, Texas. And we are doing the same. Alhamdulillah. We just got a church, 8,000 square feet in 2 acres by 1.5. 1.5 million. 1,500,000. We divided the shares of that to 1,000 people. Is that fair enough? 1.5 million divided by 1,000 people, it's gonna be 1,500, 1,500 per person. Do we have somebody today can share, can have a share of that place of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala masjid? I don't want to tell you what we're doing, but at least we are trying to leave that place as a legacy for us when we meet Rabbil Alameen subhanahu wa ta'ala. When I'm asking you right now to donate for that masjid, I know everybody coming to ask for different reasons. But by the way, this is our responsibility about our deen here. How many homes you have? Tell me, I will not tell your wife, don't worry. How many homes you have? I have two. The first one in the masjid, the first one in the masjid, and the second one my home. That's what I'm, this is my deal with Rabbil Alameen. This personally, I'm talking to you. Wallahi al-Azim, Rabbi subhanahu wa ta'ala is a witness. I have my masjid, the first home, and the second one is my wife's home, if you can say that. Subhanallah. But when I meet Rabbil Alameen subhanahu wa ta'ala that day, he will ask me about my wife's home. But the first one I'm considering is the masjid, giving my life. I don't want to say my time. This is our responsibility about the deen here. We need to increase our children, the ilm in our children, and we need to increase their iman. اللهم بلغنا مرادنا يا رب واقض حوائجنا يا رب ويسر أمورنا يا رب ودبر ما بين أيدينا يا رب بلغنا مرادنا في طاعتك يا رب نسألك ربنا أن تعفو عنا وأن تتلطف بنا وأن ترحم ضعفنا وأن تقيل عثراتنا وأن تجبر كسرنا وأن تهيئ لنا من أمرنا رشدا. نسألك ربنا أن تعافنا في أبداننا وأموالنا وعيالنا، وأن تكتب نجاتنا وأن تسلمنا من كل سوء ومن كل شر. ربنا اغفر لنا وارحمنا وتب علينا واستجب دعانا. ربنا بلغنا ما تريد لنا من الخير. ربنا أعنا على أن نستكمل ما أودعتنا من أمانة البلاغ عن دينك. اللهم أعنا على ما استأمنتنا عليه من أمانة البلاغ، واجعلنا يا رب شهودا للناس، واجعلنا يا رب شهودا بين يدي الخلق. اللهم لا تعذبنا بقول، اللهم لا تعذبنا بقول، اللهم لا تعذبنا بقول، ولا تبتلينا بانتفاء الإخلاص. ونسألك ربنا الثبات على الهداية، وأن تأخذ بنواصينا إلى ما يرضيك. اللهم ثبتنا بالقول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ويوم يقوم الأشهاد. اللهم آمين يا رب العالمين. Humbly, I'm asking you just to set like a few minutes after the salah, please. Firstly, I'm asking if you can have a share in that place. 1500 will be good for all of us. By the way, we got a loan, 1.5 million divided by 3 years. The first year, we already paid half a million, and the second, 2021, 2022, this is 2023, the last payment. You know, I know I didn't ask you for that reason at the beginning, but I'm asking you at the end. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give the reward for the people they started the project, I'm sure Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us a reward to like seal the deal, khalas, done, inshaAllah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help all of us. Wallahi laysa lana ghaya wala gharad إلا سداد بيتي سداد دين بيت الله تبارك وتعالى. فأعينونا بقوة. أسأل الله لي ولكم السلامة، وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
استقيموا
استقيموا.
الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. والعاديات ضبحا فالموريات قدحا فالمغيرات صبحا فأثرن به نقعا فوسقن به جمعا إن الإنسان لربه لكنود وإنه على ذلك لشهيد وإنه لحب الخير لشديد أفلا يعلم إذا بعثر ما في القبور وحصل ما في الصدور إن ربهم بهم يومئذ لخبير. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.